So, ladies and gentlemen, we are back at the IDS 2021. This is the product stage, and I'm very happy that you are with us. Coming up next is an interview about VITA ENAMIC restorations with a VITA accent, Elke. Stains, and the host of this session is the VITA Zahnfabrik, and therefore we have Dr. Michael Tholey, head of technical service at VITA Zahnfabrik, with us, as well as, and she is in the interview, Dr. Bernhild Elke Stamnitz as a dentist. So we have a short opener, and then we start with you two.
Thanks. So, yeah, Elke, Bernhild Elke Stamnitz, she's with me today here in Cologne, and I'm really happy to have you here on the stage on the IDS 2021. And yeah, Bernhild, you are a dentist since now over 20 years, isn't it?
Yeah, almost 20 years now, and yeah, I'm actually, we are talking about VITA ENAMIC, and I'm working at about 10 years with this material. Yeah, and would like to show you some cases here.
Oh, that's really good, because Elke, she is something special. She's doing a lot of anterior crowns, and this is unique in the dentist area, in my opinion, because a lot of your colleagues actually are doing almost only posterior teeth. And so, yeah, could you show me some anterior crowns and the result and your success with them?
Yes, I can. I just took one of my favorite cases, which you can see here in the presentation. It was quite a challenge to find the right color to find the right color and the right fitting. Because if you have a look at the screen, you see the size of the darker tooth. It's a tooth number 21. So, and the size was also quite difficult to do. And I think I take you a little bit more into the subject. This is on the left side, you see the original case, and on the right side, you see the preparation. And it wasn't only about the preparation. It looks quite good here, but what you can't see is still the size of the tooth. It was like, it was a little bit more into the anterior area, and we had to do some diagnostics. We had to check the size of the tooth, and this is what we did, a little measurement, and you see the distance. You see it's much bigger than the other tooth.
Uh-huh. Cool. And what did you do next? So, because the size of the tooth is really complicated, and you did a check, and then how did you design the crown? How was your workflow for this?
Yeah, we had the choice to do orthodontic treatment. The patient didn't want to have an orthodontic treatment, so we decided to find the right fitting for this patient.
And why not the orthodontic treatment? So why was the choice of the patient not to choose the orthodontic treatment?
He didn't want to do it.
Okay.
It just took him too much time.
Okay.
And he wanted to get rid of this awful looking crown, actually. It was a temporary crown he wore it for about 20 years, and he just didn't want to have it anymore, and that's why he wanted to have it fast. The decision was done, and he wanted to have it fast fixed.
Okay.
Yeah.
So lots of pressure for you.
Right? Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So what you see here on this screen on the right side is the restoration without any fitting, just the fitting on the tooth, of course, but we didn't do the coloring part on this tooth. And I will take you a little bit more. We used the new VITA ENAMIC colors, and we actually used a little printed model to find the right fittings because of the difficult situation of this tooth. So on the top you see the milled crown, mm-hmm. top of the top light, and on the bottom you see the finished restoration.
So you only work with scanning of the situation in the mouth and then printing the model, and this is your workflow?
Yes, we did. We grinded in a CEREC machine with ENAMIC blocks, which is quite fast and very predictable. The fittings are just perfect. It just fits on a tooth. You have no gaps, nothing. And you can do the restoration quite thin. And and then you can really work on anterior teeth because you don't need to take so much of the tooth material away. And that's quite, it's really good for us as dentists and of course for the patients,
Cool. So, you can mill so precise that it's just fit.
Yeah, even if you do veneers, it's just, you don't need to take much away, or just non-prep veneers, it's just easy to do, But I will take you a little bit more into this case. You see the original part on the left, and on the right you see the finished crown. And it was nice to do the coloring of the tooth. We could use all the natural tooth color, like some white, some yellowish. And you see also the transparent area in the incisal area. Yeah, and that was quite good to do.
And how was your feeling with the new Accent LC material?
I'm used to use the, I would call it the old colors, but these colors are much better because they're already in liquids. So we just needed to shake them for a little bit and then we could use them straight away. And the result, the outcome from the colors which you put on the teeth, it's the same. It's always the same. You know exactly what you get. And that's nice.
Cool. Yeah. So that's good to hear. So our R&D department did a good job here.
But I have another case which I would like to show. This is quite an interesting case. It's about a person who lost his front tooth. It was broken in the middle. And he fixed it himself with some resin. I don't know how he did it, but he did it for years.
So himself.
He did it himself. Yeah.
He went to the tomb or somewhere and got some plaster and.
I think he went into the hardware store and got some material which he put into the tooth. You see the tooth, how he fixed it on the top of the right side.
Wow.
And but he got pain, and so we had to take the tooth out. And now the question was, how can we solve the problem? Because it's a big gap there, which you can also see on these pictures. And we decided to use a smile design. And he achieved an implant on this tooth, but it was still the gap, which was far too big.
Okay.
So we decided to give him a veneer on a tooth 1-1. And the result you see on the left side on the bottom. It's a veneer on a tooth 1-1 and implant restoration on a 2-1. It's both done out of ENAMIC for implants and the other one just ENAMIC multicolor. And then we use the stains, the new stains. Yeah.
Okay, and the patient did he have a diastema or something like this?
No, he said he didn't have it, but I mean, you see the size of the tooth and I think he had something like that and it was quite difficult to tell him we have to put something on the other tooth, like a veneer, to close the gap. And this is what he wanted.
And the veneer on the tooth 1-1, that's very thin, actually, I think.
Yeah, it's a non-prep. Veneer.
Okay, completely non-preparation.
Completely non-prep. And it was good to do because I can grind it so thin, this material. That's quite
cool. It's a nice case, actually. And it's really, it looks natural now when you see the teeth. It looks absolutely natural. And I think he's happy, isn't it?
Oh, yes, he is. Very, You left me last week in a practice, in a surgery, and he said, okay, my time with the mask is over. I will just have a little foil in it that everybody can see my smile now.
Cool.
But I think he has to wait a little bit longer.
cool. That's, yeah, to see such a result in such a successful patient, I think that's the best, actually, the best thing for a dentist, isn't it?
Yeah. It's predictable.
Yeah.
And that's what I like. You know, I know exactly what I will get if I do this kind of restorations. Of course, you need experience, but it's predictable and it's nice. Yeah.
Cool.
I have another.
Yeah, of course.
Would you like
to see
the other one as well? This is also an anterior tooth. It was broken, and we didn't have the time to print a model or something like that. We just had to do it straight away. And it was also done with ENAMIC and also with the new colors. It takes about 1.5 hours, and from the start, from the preparation, of course, we used to take a lot of pictures, and until the crown is inside this person's mouth, yeah.
Very, very good. So, if someone is coming to you and you do first the check, how his situation is, and then you give him the next appointment, and he can go home without a second visit, actually, isn't it?
Yeah, we can do it just straight away in one appointment. Sometimes you have to do it, of course. And sometimes you need a little bit more about preparation, like the cases you saw. We need a little bit of smile design to find the right way for the patients. And sometimes they come actually with their own pictures, their own ideas, or old pictures, what they used to look like. And that's a big challenge for us to put it into the restoration and give it to this patient. Yeah.
So we saw now three cases with VITA-ENAMIC in the anterior area. Where are you using VITA-ENAMIC? Just for anteriors, for fast, really nice looking anterior restorations, or is it something else? Are there some more?
Oh, well, I like to use ENAMIC for implant restorations, like a mesostructure. I like it for veneers, of course, for anterior crowns, for actually the molar area as well, because it's fast. It has a really good strength, this material, for inlays or crown lays. And this, yeah, we use it for all kinds of indications, actually. And what I really like is when the people have it in the mouth, they close it, they try it, and say, yeah, it's like as it used to be.
Yeah, I have also an inlay of VITA-ENAMIC, but yeah, I can say it feels like a natural tooth, that's true. So, and if someone is here watching us and he thinks, okay, Bernhild, Elke, Stamnitz can show me something and can teach me with some things, where can they find you? Where is your practice? Where is your maybe next training, lecture, and things like this?
Yeah, I'm here today. We have two lectures in Hall 10-1, I think, the VITA booth. And my surgery is in Langen, it's close to Frankfurt, and I'm doing courses in Berlin, in Bad Säcking, in Langen, yeah, everywhere. Or online courses, I have done quite a lot international now during Corona. And yeah, just contact Michael.
Of course, you can contact me as well. So, yeah, I think I say thank you. And I think it was very interesting for everybody because of your cases. I think the one with the non-prep veneer and the implant case is the most interesting to me. From interest, I think that's the most hard case, actually. And yeah, I say thanks to you.
Thank you very much.
So, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm back again. And thank you, too, for this amazing start. It was the first session here on this stage. And as you just mentioned, you have a booth here at the IDS. So if someone is able to come here to Cologne, then
the
come
VITA
to...
The VITA booth, 10.1.
Perfect. So thank you very much. You
thank
too.
You.